Dan Whaley was not only born to run.
I started in sixth grade. I started running track and field.
He likes to run the way he was born, or close to it.
By the time I got to high school, I had moved into more of the elite level amongst all the high school runners.
Now Dan sells those barefoot style or minimum running shoes that are all the rage.
With these, the five fingers force you to run on your forefoot. You do not strike on your heel at all. And it's very fluid. It's a constant motion. Your momentum is just solid all the way through.
As more people experiment with barely their shoes, doctors are seeing more injuries. From pulled muscles to stress fractures, it usually stems from starting too quickly.
I wouldn't say, you know what, you need to chuck your shoes out and go for a 30-minute run barefoot today.
Physical therapist Kath Kinross says to take it slow, you have to walk before you can run, so to speak.
The next time you go to the beach, the first 5 minutes, try a run without the shoes. The next time you go, try 10 minutes and kind of build up gradually that way. And then maybe try taking it to a firmer surface, like the edge of a golf course.
Today's running shoes are cushioned to protect the feet and help the heel-striking runners minimize discomfort. Going barefoot or minimal strips those benefits.
You've really got to kind of weigh up the pros and the cons, and for those of us who are not elite athletes, there are some significant cons that we really need to take into consideration.
If you're running to enjoy good health, you'll want to be cautious to see what's right for you and not get carried away by a fad. For Lee Memorial Health System, I'm Amy Osher.